You're looking up.
Let's see what we came for.
Thank you.
One hell of a hangar.
Look at all this space.
So, the central elevator's through here.
And out of the loading bay.
Your Majesty, your precious crystal awaits you. To liven things up, I thought I'd take you on a stroll down memory lane. Of course, memories decay with time.
hunt you down.
Don't say that.
Yeah!
A sorry end for the High Commander. For anyone. He was a man with hopes and dreams.
Ugh. It's horrible.
What kind of fiend makes demons of men?
Look alive! Company!
Don't die on me.
Do you suppose your dear friends are still alive? Those who died for you, do you ever wonder what went through their minds? Can you even recall their final words?
I'll come back for you all. I swear. How far does this go? Crystal had better be here. Everyone's counting on it. Counting on me.
Your journey is over, Noct.
Monsters the likes of which you've seen. elusive little savior who could cure the afflicted. His body would come to host myriad demons, let countless lives be spared. But a jealous king, one chosen by the crystal, ostracized and demonized this healer of the people, making a true monster of him. I gave you my name earlier, but you should know that it was not the name given to me at birth. Arden Lucis Kylum is my proper name. You'll never guess whose name this linear was. Killing this mortal will bring me satisfaction. Playing the crystal's power, arise as its champion. Only once the crystal and the king are no more. I know redemption. Come back soon. I shall keep your friends coming to you.
Strength, O Chosen. Eternal, who whose immortality stems from the self-same scourge that wrought the demons. One so impure of body and soul was deemed unworthy of the crystal's light and forbidden to ascend. His mind twisted by spite and bent on revenge, the usurper came to bring darkness down upon our world. Only the true king, chosen by the crystal and guarded by his forebears, can end the accursed's madness. It is the sole means to ending the immortal accursed. A power greater than even that of the Six, purifying all by the light of the crystal and the glaives of rulers past. Only at the throne can the Chosen receive it, and only at the cost of a life his own. Shall be granted the power to banish the darkness, but the blood price must be paid. To cast out the usurper and usher in Dawn's light will cost the life of the Chosen. Many sacrificed all for the king, so must the king sacrifice himself for all. Enter into reflection, let the light of Providence shine within.
Be waiting. And Hammerhead. Maasai out. Everywhere. What the hell happened? Last man standing. What is it, boy? Something's coming. A truck?
Uh,
Yeah?
It's me, Talcott. My grandpa served the Amasidia family.
Talcott?
Yeah.
No way.
Yes way. Welcome back, Your Majesty. Yes, sir. That's right. Huh? Just a second. Said he wants to have a word with you.
He can have it in person.
He said you can have it in person. Okay. We should be there shortly, sir. Wow. I can't tell you how good it is to see you again.
Yeah, you sure look different, though.
You think so? Guess I've grown some these 10 years.
10 years?
The guys must be pinching themselves right now.
Where are they, anyway?
Listalem, more often than not, but they take a lot of trips to Hammerhead.
For?
For Miss Cindy. You know, back at the garage. She's a tough one, but when she needs a little extra muscle out on the road, she gives them a call.
Huh.
Oh, speaking of which, the guys said they're near Hammerhead right now, so we'll be meeting them there. You know, ever since you disappeared, Your Majesty, it's been nothing but nighttime, nonstop. Listalem still has light, thanks to the power plant, so just about everyone's taken refuge there.
Only there?
Everywhere else has been abandoned. Demons moved in, forcing the people to move out. People still swing by the garage at Hammerhead from time to time, but it usually isn't for repairs. These days it's less of a service station and more of a slayer station, a base for demon hunting. The garage is still open, though. One of the few places that is.
So, Cid, he's still alive and kicking.
He's kicking all right, just not as hard as before. He hasn't really been himself lately. At least, not since he moved out to Listalem. Someone suggested he move the garage there too, but old man Cid wasn't having it. He called it a big fat chocobo turd of an idea. Said it just wouldn't be the same anywhere else.
That sounds like Cid, all right.
Miss Cindy said she didn't mind either way. So the garage will probably stay put for a while. And without any tinkering to do, Ignis's gourmet seafood is about all Cid has left to look forward to. With all the demons prowling around, more folk were getting hurt. Or worse. So Iris talked the Marshal into taking out the demons themselves. Iris the Demon Slayer, they call her. Gladio and the others, they lend him a hand whenever they can. Prompto spends most of his time hunting around Hammerhead. He tries to impress Miss Cindy, but she's already married to her work.
And Ignis?
He hunts, too. We tried to stop him, but he wouldn't listen. He said if anything, he's more used to the darkness than we are.
Never got his vision back.
I'm afraid not. But that being said, he gets by pretty well on his own. Gladio and Prompto usually hunt on their own as well. It isn't often you see the three of them together nowadays. They still work as a team every once in a while, but each has his own set of tasks to keep him busy.
Is that so?
We've arrived, Your Majesty. Everyone will be so happy to see you. Don't worry. I won't be going anywhere. If you have any other questions, please don't hesitate to ask.
That's all you have to say for yourself after all this time?
Knocked! It's you! It's really you!
I hadn't realized.
Well, well. You kept us waiting.
Not like I wanted to. We've got catching up to do. Let's head inside.